Alright, so well done, guys, for the two films that were showcased. So, just like before, does anyone from the audience have any questions before we start? You?
It's really spoken to you. What inspired you? That was your inspiration for the film.
Was that a wet dream?
my wet dreams have a different meaning. was a wet dream. I think at the time, because I do stand up as well, and I think I was just feeling like, you know, sometimes it's frustrating stand up because you go up on stage and people expect a certain thing, and it's hard to break out of that mold. I know when I go up on stage, people are expecting me to do some political shit, and sometimes I want to talk about cereal. Even now, that makes nobody believes me. That's fine. You know, there's just like, it's almost like living up, like, it's not just life, you have to live up to expectations even on stage, man, and even as a black stand-up in front of, like, it's like, and it was frustrating because I don't feel, sometimes, yeah, I mean, to me, making people laugh, doing black material is easy. So sometimes I feel, even though I'm having a, you know, what looks like a great show, and I'm not being arrogant, sometimes I really do bomb. It doesn't feel, it's not always fulfilling.
Yeah.
Because I know that I'm just pandering. So that, yeah, that was it. I wanted to sort of leave stand-up for a while and just do my own thing. Does that make sense?
I was just inspired by, you know, conversations that you have with people all the time. And with my writer in particular, we have conversations about like conspiracy and like what ifs and what cans, and like if these things happen, what would it be like? And crossing that with just everyday life, and just getting to see what would that look like if these scientific things was happening in the world that we didn't know about, and what if it was happening right under our noses? So yeah, I had the idea, and I kind of just like pitched it to my writer, and then I pitched it to my director, and then we kind of developed the idea and go on from there. So, and I like telling films that are slightly out of this world. I really like the sci-fi world and fantasy world, kind of like you lot's film. So it's always interesting.
Yeah.
Another quick one. How was it directing yourself?
Oh boy. Jesus.
I was gonna ask that.
Jesus.
But it looked intense.
Oh, you say
it looked intense.
It looked intense.
Yeah, it was sometimes, because it was like, you know, an intense scene, and I had to watch that intense scene again, then do that intense scene again, after watching myself just do it very intensely. sometimes Moses was there, so Moses was like, if Moses, I'd be like, oh, Moses is that good, because he was the only guy I trusted.
Yeah.
Didn't trust anyone else, because I didn't really know him. And that's what I learned as well. You really have to trust the people you're working with.
Yeah,
yeah, for sure.
Yeah,
you already have your own rights, so you're good.
Yeah. it's just having the right team, I think. You got to just trust that. You know, and as an actor, after experience, you kind of go, yeah, that was the take, that was the one. And then you go, oh, maybe we should do that again. But I was directed in Capture. But as a producer, just knowing that, I go, take this hat off and put on my acting hat.
Sure, yeah.
And just know that it's time to just be the character and be in that moment.
Sure.
So
Moses would tell me when it's
not good. You know when it's not good as well.
Yeah.
The other actors are looking at each other and we're like, yeah, we should all do that again. You know.
Because that's quite different from like the typical standard of filmmaking in itself, where you just have a straight actor, director, and writer in their roles. Because even then, with actors looking at their own footage, it's considered taboo. Because an actor can just do all these minuscule changes that really F up the whole continuity of the edit. So obviously for that, you're right in terms of like having a great team to have that shared vision and just be able to have respect for both like each of your roles. And
sure,
so I commend you both for doing that.
Yeah,
you
know? Thank you.
Thank you so much. Can we give them one round of applause? Thank you guys. We're gonna go to the next one.